In this session, I will explain about pure resistive circuit. This is a circuit diagram which consists of a pure resistance represented by R connected across a voltage source, and this voltage source is AC, which is represented by V. Let the current flowing through the circuit be represented by I. Then if we see the waveforms of this pure resistive circuit, it can be represented in this way. Let this be the voltage waveform, which is represented by small v, indicating that it is instantaneous voltage. At any instant, it will have different values on the waveform. And the current waveform is represented in this way, and this is the current waveform, and it is plotted in this way. The time is taken along x-axis, and the amplitudes of current and voltages are taken along the y-axis. So this is pi value and this is 2 pi on the time axis. So these are nothing but the waveforms of current and voltage. Now let us consider the phasor diagram. The phasor diagram can be represented in this way. If this is the voltage which is represented along the x-axis, then the current can also be represented along the same axis like this, indicating that both current and voltage are on the same axis, because there is no phase difference between voltage and current. Both are starting at the same time. The time difference is not there between voltage and current. So they are in phase with each other. They are reaching their maximum value at the same time, that is pi by 2. And they are reaching again 0 at pi value. They are reaching negative value of maximum value at 3 pi by 2. And they are reaching 0 at 2 pi value. So this indicates they are taking their maximum value or zero values at the same time. So they are in phase with each other. Current and voltage are in phase with each other, and they are represented in this way in the phasor diagram. Now let the voltage V be represented by Vm sine omega t, because this is a sine function. Voltage is a sine function, as well as current is also a sine function here. Now we know that from Ohm's law, I is given by V by R. And we know what is V from equation number 1. V is Vm sine omega t divided by this R. This is the value of the current, instantaneous current. So Vm by R is nothing but, this is Vm. Vm by R is nothing but I only. That is Im. Im, remaining thing same, sine omega t. Because Vm divided by R is nothing but V by R is I, that is Im, maximum value of current. So this is how the instantaneous current I can be represented as Im, that is maximum of value of current, sine function of omega t. Now let us consider the power. power in a pure resistive circuit is given by P, and this power is equivalent to the average power also, and this power is given by Vm Im by 2. We know that power is the product of voltage into current, so this is given as Vm into Im divided by 2, and this can be further split as Vm by root 2 into Im divided by root 2. Root 2 into root 2 is 2, so Vm by root 2 into Im by root 2, and Vm by root 2 is nothing but V, that is RMS value of alternating quantity, that is voltage, and this Im by root 2 is nothing but I, that is steady state value or effective value or RMS values of alternating quantity, voltage and current. So this, from this we can say that power is nothing but V into I, that is average power. Now real power, if we consider, this real power is given by, if I take this real power as PR, this is equal to VI cos theta. And we know that there is no phase difference between current and voltage. The phase difference between current and voltage is 0. Here also the phase difference is 0. So this is equal to V into I into cos of phase difference between current and voltage is 0. So this is equal to cos of 0 is 1. 1 into VI is VI. So the real power is given by VI, which is also called as apparent power. And power factor is given by cos theta, and we know that cos of theta is 0 here, so this is equal to 1. So the power factor of pure resistive circuit is always equal to 1. This is all about the pure resistive circuit, in which we have discussed a simple pure resistive circuit by considering its waveform and phasor diagram. We have seen the relationship between current and voltage, and also the real power, which is also called as apparent power, and we have also seen the average power, and we calculated the power factor of the pure resistive circuit, which is always equal to 1. Thank you.